Good morning, dear students, and a warm welcome for this catechism class. So, some of you are still writing the exams, some of you are still preparing for the exams. So, I wish all of you all the best for your exams. Do well. May God bless you and give you all the needed strength to do well in your exams. So, last time, I gave you one worksheet. And I appreciate most of you have responded to me and submitted the worksheet. So thank you for all your willingness to listen to the classes and do the assigned works. So last time we studied about the Mary doing the will of God and Joseph resigning to the will of God, and they both get married, and through the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus is born in a small town called Bethlehem. So today we are going to reflect about the birth of Christ, the incarnate Son of God, becoming a small child and coming into the world. That is, Word became flesh and dwelt among us like humans. So let us begin our class with a short prayer. Please join your hands and close your eyes, students. God, my Father, I thank and praise you for the gift of this day and for all your blessings you have bestowed on us. Thank you for this new week which we are beginning, the new opportunities you have set before us, the new blessings which you are going to pour upon us, the miracles which you have kept for us during this week. Lord, help us always to be open to ourselves to receive your blessings. Help us that we may be able to understand your will, your plan in our life, and give us a heart, the heart that of gratitude, to always thank and praise you for becoming man for our sake and dying for us on the cross for our sake. Thank you for this great love which you have shown to us, through which you tell us how much God the Father loves us. Lord, as we reflect today about your birth, which brought joy to many more people, help us to have the joy of receiving you every day in our heart. Be with us, dear Lord, during this day and all the days to come. May your blessings be upon us. This prayer I make to you, dear Lord, in your holy name. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, last time we studied about Mary and Joseph. Today we are going to study about the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem. So your topic for today is, He is born in Bethlehem. The aim from this chapter you are going to get is to accept Jesus as Savior. Jesus came to this world to save us from sin. So he took a form of a babe and came to dwell among us in the form of a human being. So during this whole week, let us thank Jesus for becoming flesh and dwelling among us as a human being, and accept Jesus as our Savior who saved us from the bondage of sin. So, repeatedly say during this week, Jesus, my Savior, I thank you. Whenever you are getting the free time, go on telling this word saying, Jesus, my Savior, I thank you. And Jesus will surely solve all your problems. When you are writing your paper also, say, Jesus, my Savior, help me. He will surely help you. So when the whole world was in sin, when people cried out to God, God sent his only son whom he loved so much. And Jesus willingly accepted the humanity in his bosom and came to this world to save us. So let us take Jesus as our Savior and go keep thanking him during this whole week. So there are many occasions in our life, students. There are many occasions wherein we are feeling happy for. So there are many occasions in life called our birthdays, which is a great day for us. We will be waiting when we will celebrate our birthday, because there will be cakes, there will be new clothes which your parents are going to get for you, and there is a joy for you to go to the school with your sweet box in your hand, go on distributing, all will shake hand, so all will wish you, teacher will make a prayer for you. So that is a kind of a happy occasion in your life, wherein you feel happy. And in some of the people life, there is some happy occasion when they get a good job, right? So when they get a good job, first they will thank God. After that, the thing they are doing is they go and share the sweets. Sharing their happiness means sharing their happiness for their hard labor. They have got a reward. The reward is nothing but a job. So they go and share the sweets with all the friends and their neighbors, whoever are staying with them. And the next happy occasion is when we get our results, especially the board exams, when we pass our 10th standard. No, it is a kind of a great event in our life, from where we pass on to next year, okay, or a next academic year, where we go from school to the new life of college. So in our life also, from when you go from fourth to fifth, after your results, you go and distribute the sweets to your neighbors or to your friends, because you are sharing your happiness with others. And some of the happy occasions in the world, we see when any political party is going to win, the leaders of the party or the other people share their happiness by sharing the sweets. So that is one more happy occasion. Now in the family, the happy occasion is a birth of a newborn baby. So if you have some brothers or sisters who are going to take birth in your family, you may be eagerly waiting, who will be arriving in my family, whether it is a brother or it is a sister. So you will be waiting when your mother is going to give birth to a new child. More than you, the mother, you will be waiting. So whether I will have a sister or whether I will have a brother. So there will be a lot of expectation. So when the baby comes into the world, you are the first one who will be eager to see the baby. And then you come home and share your happiness by sharing the sweets with everyone, saying, I got a sister, I got a brother, like that. So you share your happiness to all the world or your neighbors or your friends. So that is a happy event in your life. So family rejoices at the birth of a baby. So sometimes family, your grandparents, your grandmother, if it is a joint family, all will come to the hospital to see which baby is born. So let us see, because it's a new face coming into the world, coming into our family. There is an added member to our family. So the family rejoices, maybe it's grandparents. Sometimes like you also will come to the hospital many times when your mother is not there. You feel the absence of your mother. And most of you are eager to go and play with your younger brother or a sister. So you come to the hospital, touch the tiny hands of the brothers or the sister, and you experience the joy of getting a brother or a sister. And parents also feel happy, because that is the fruit of their love. Okay, so the family rejoices at the birth of a baby. So now in the Old Testament, when we go, there are people who experience joy or who experience the great happiness when they got the child at their old age. So the first example from the Old Testament who got the child at the 100th year of their life was Abraham and Sarah. You can see all they have, both have got a gray hairs, you may experience. So at that age, they got a baby whom they named as Isaac. Okay, this is our father of faith. You have heard about Abraham's story. Okay, so Sarah didn't have children, so she gives her maid servant Hagar. Then Hagar conceives, but when Sarah came to know that she started feeling jealous because Hagar's son, that is Ishmael, is playing with Isaac. She asked Abraham to send her away. But you see the joy in the face of Abraham and Sarah, because Sarah was called to be barren, okay, and God looked upon her and she conceived and bore a son whom she gave a name called as Isaac. So you see the happiness in the family of Abraham when they got a baby. And the second happiness whom we see in the Old Testament is Manoah and Zelphoni. These are the parents of Samson. Last time I showed you a pick of Samson, who had a great strength in his hair. Okay, so these are the parents of Samson. Okay, these are the so they also were quite old. You can see the age of theirs in the pick which is displayed on the PPT. So they also got a child when they were very, very old. So they didn't have child. So when they didn't have a child, it is a disgrace to the mother or a wife. So many people will be speaking. So you don't have, God might have cursed you, all things they have to listen. But Manoah and Zelphoni, that is Samson's parents, prayed, and God, angel Gabriel, came to give the message that she is going to conceive and she will give birth to a son. That is the fruit of their love for each other and the faith they had in God. Samson was born, and they shared their happiness in all the neighborhood, because all the disgrace that was on Zelphoni was taken away by God to the birth of a child, that is Samson. And the next we have Boaz and Ruth. So these are the great character. Ruth was already married, so she lost her husband at a very young age. And after that, she was with her mother-in-law called as Naomi. And she said, your God will be my God and your people will be my people. She said, Naomi told her to go back to her parents, to her home. But Ruth said, I'm not going to go. Your God will be my God and your people will be my people. So she stayed with Naomi, and in the process, she meets a young man called as Boaz, who was a relative of Naomi. So she was working in Boaz's field. So Boaz fell in love with her. And after that, they got married with each other. And as the fruit of their love for each other, Obed was born. Obed was nothing but he was the father of Jesse. And Jesse was the father of King David. Okay, so this is the life of Ruth. So after losing her husband, after the death of her husband, she married Boaz, and as the fruit, they gave birth and they shared their happiness. And Naomi was overwhelmed with joy for blessing Ruth with a new husband and blessing the child. Okay, so they share their happiness with the birth of a child called as Obed. And this is one more character in the Old Testament whom we found as Elkanah and Hannah. Okay, Elkanah was a man of God. So he has two wives. Okay, the first wife had children, But Hannah didn't had children, so she used to pray and pray to so many gods, so to the true God, that is God the Father. So one day, Eli, who was in the temple, who was a temple priest of he saw her and he gave her the message. So God will look favorably on you. So God took heard the prayer of Hannah, and as their love for each other, Prophet Samuel was born through Hannah. Okay, Prophet Samuel came to Prophet Samuel was a son of Hannah and Elkanah, who brought joy to this couple. Okay, so the disgrace of Hannah was taken away and Hannah gave birth to Samuel. So this was, these are the all the characters of the Old Testament who shared their joy for what the God has done in their life. So let's go for New Testament, whom we have, as we have reflected most of the time. Last time when I said about Mary, we have spoken about this this couple, that is none other than Saint John the Baptist's parents. They are Zechariah and Elizabeth. So when Mary was greeted by angel, and when she said that, how can I conceive and bear a son? Angel Gabriel said, your kinswoman Elizabeth is now in her 6 months. So nothing is impossible to God. Everything is possible to God. So at their old age, this couple called as Elizabeth and Zechariah gave birth to a great man called as Saint John the Baptist, and they shared their joy in the gospel. When you read the gospel of Luke about Saint John the Baptist, you will go to see how the neighbors rejoiced at the birth of Saint John the Baptist. Okay, so these are the great characters in the Bible whom we say with the birth of a baby, how it brought joy not only to the parents, but also to the neighbors, their friends, their family members. So all rejoiced. So many people people's life was enlightened, was blessed by God by the birth of a baby in their family, a new added member to their family. So now there is a great character. So there is a season of joy, okay, whom we celebrate. So you can see the very many pictures. So when you see the pictures on the PPT, you can see these all the pictures, like Santa Claus, then the kuswar which we prepare, then the new clothes, crib, band, star. All these things come during the time of Christmas, which season we call that season is a season of joy. Not only Catholics, there are other faiths also, people of other faith who celebrate this great feast, that is the birth of Jesus. Okay, birth of Jesus, whom we all celebrate with greater joy. Okay, now the birth of Jesus, not only birth of Jesus brought joy to Joseph, to Mother Mary, and not only to the parents, but also there were persons who didn't know about Mary and Joseph. They were outcast people. They were neglected by the society. They were none others than shepherds. Okay, shepherds was given a great message of joy, saying, your Savior has born to this world. Go and see him. You will find a baby wrapped in a swaddling clothes. So it was a great message for the shepherd, great news of joy for the shepherd, because their Savior has come to this world. So you see, Jesus himself has said, I am the shepherd and you are my sheep. So the first message of joy of birth of Jesus was given to the shepherds, and the rejoicing message was the people who rejoiced at the birth of Christ was Joseph, Mary, and the poor shepherds. So let us read the word of God from the Bible. Please take your Bible, students, and take Luke chapter 2, verse 1 to 21. So I am going to read from the From the verse 8, okay? I'm going to read from verse 8. So you go to read, you start reading from chapter 1 to 21. I'm shortening the passage. In the region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you the good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what has been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ. So you saw in the gospel how the shepherds were given the message. So they saw a great multitude of angels and who are praising God, saying glory to God in the highest. And they were given the message, "To you is born today the Savior in a town of David." Okay. Town of David, that is Bethlehem. So go and see, go and meet your Savior. So they went with great joy to see this child. Only it was Mother Mary and Joseph who saw the birth of Christ for the first time. And this first time was to see Jesus. This great news was given only to shepherds and not to great kings, but this least and the downtrodden people. So Jesus' birth brought many good things to all the people of this world. So it brought a great joy to many people. So let us during this week, so when we celebrate the season of Christmas, it is not only it is a season of jubilation, but about that you have to keep on thanking God during that season of Christmas, saying, "Thank you, Jesus, for coming to this world. Thank you for saving us from the bondage of sin. If Jesus would not have come in a form of a babe, we would be in bondage of sin." So let us try to share about Jesus to many more people. So during the time of Christmas, let us go out of ourselves, do the works of charity, giving our clothes, giving the sweets which are prepared. So go and share this joyful message of birth of Jesus to all the people. There are so many beggars in your streets. There are so many poor people whom you know. So let us go and share the joy of Christmas to all these people. And because our Christian faith say, when God became man, the Christmas story began. Okay. So if God would not have become man, we would not have a Christmas story. We would not have this joyful celebration of celebrating Christmas. So let us share our happiness with all the people of the world and let us become the instrument of peace. So Saint Francis of Xavier calls us, "Make me an instrument of peace." So Jesus came as a Prince of Peace. So we call Jesus as a Prince of Peace because he brought He came to this world to be the Prince of Peace, to bring unity among people. So we call him as a Prince of Peace. So let us not go and divide the relationship, but be the children of Jesus by vibrating, sending the vibration of peace to everyone with whomever we are going to stay with. So let us become the instrument of peace to the whole world, especially to our neighbors and to our friends and all those who come in contact with our life. So the homework will be sent to you. There will be a worksheet which I have not posted today. So I will post it in your group. So do the homework, complete the notes, and have a good day. All the best. So all the best. Do well your exam. Do well in your exam, students. So let us join hands for the concluding prayer. So read this time from Luke chapter 1, Luke chapter 2, whole thing. Okay. So keep on reading the word of God. And if possible, read the book of Genesis, Abraham's story. Then read the book of Judges, where we see the birth of Samson, and read the first book of Samuel, where we hear the prayer of Hannah, his mother. Read the book of Luke, where we find the story of Zechariah and Elizabeth, how they share their joy through the birth of Saint John the Baptist. And read the book of Ruth, where we find the story of Ruth. Is a small book, okay? So you can read it very fast. So read the book and try to get the message from these testaments, and get a message for your life. Join your hands for your concluding prayer, students. God, my Father, I thank and praise you for sending your only Son, Jesus, to this world. Jesus, I thank you for coming to this world, for taking a form of a human and dwelling among us as one of us. Thank you for coming to this world and saving us from the bondage of sin. Dear Lord, the shepherd recognized you as their savior, and they shared their joy and they went home rejoicing for all that they have seen and heard. And they preached this joy of your birth to the whole world with whomever they meet. Help us, dear Lord, during the time of Christmas and in the days to come, to share about you, to share the happiness of your birth with all those whom we come in contact with. May your blessings be upon us. May you lead us, guide us, and direct us to take you as the savior of our life. This prayer I make to you, dear Lord, in your holy name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So thank you, students, and God bless you all.